A warm welcome you all for a video lecture session on control system and PLC for a program electronics and telecommunication engineering of semester 5th. Me, myself, Professor Ashok Bhajantri, lecturer in electronics and telecommunication engineering department at Brahmadev Dada Mani Polytechnic, Bellary, Solapur. So in this session, we'll be looking into the basics of control system, which has got weightage of 12 marks. Let us look into the content of this presentation. First, we'll see the course outcome and scheme. Then we'll look into briefly syllabus content. Then starting into the unit number 1, we'll look into the basic definitions of control system. Then we shall look into types of control system, then basic examples of control system, then finally we'll look into applications of control system. So this is scheme mentioned for the subject, so which consists of course outcome. So the course actually consists of totally 5 defined course outcomes which have been classified, which have been defined. So firstly, we'll try to identify different types of control system. Second, we'll try to determine the stability of control system. Third, we shall try to test the performance of various types of controllers. Then fourthly, we'll look into how to maintain various components for a PLC based processor control system. Then we shall also learn how a PLC based processor can be maintained. And looking into the examination scheme, this subject has total weightage of 150 marks, out of which 70 marks are for end semester exam, then 30 marks are for progressive assessment, out of which 50 marks are also included for practical end semester exam. So we shall look into briefly the syllabus. So chapter number 1 is going to deal with basics of a control system. Chapter 2 will deal with time domain stability analysis. In unit number 1, that is basics of control system, the basic definition of a control system, their classification, then finding a transfer function, then block reduction techniques are discussed. So for the time being, we will discuss only the content of first chapter, process controllers. Then unit number 4. Unit number 4 and 5 are dealing with PLC, program logical controllers. So again, it's a kind of control system which is programmed. This content of chapter number 4 will be dealing in further class. And this is the total distribution of marks for the entire 5 chapters. So some of the recommended textbooks for the subjects are as shown. So now let us start with the basic introduction, and that too with a basic definition of control system. What actually is a control system? So control system is nothing but a controlling a system which is required for controlling the operation, or else we can also define in a simple way a system that can regulate itself of a system or else of another system. So combining all these, we can define a control system is nothing but a device or a set of devices whose function is to manage, command, direct or regulate the behavior of other device or a system. Now in order to define a control system, first it is essential that we have to understand what is the need of the required parameters called as controlled variable. So controlled variable is the condition by which the required parameters can be controlled. Normally controlled variable is the output of the control system. Now manipulated variable, so again it's a kind of again control system in which the system in which the variables can be adjusted depending upon the requirement of a control system. Now we have seen controlled variable, manipulated variable. So leading into both of these then will result a system called as control. Control means measuring the value of controlled variable of a system and applying the manipulated variable to the system so as to correct or so as to obtain a normal recommended level as per the requirement of a system. Now further we'll see what is system. System is nothing but an interconnection of elements and devices for a required specific purpose. Now we have defined previously control, now system, combining control system that forms an interconnection of components forming a system such that when it is processed will provide the desired response. So we have got a process. So process is nothing but a system or a plant whose function is to control the required parameter. So the entire control system is represented as shown in below block diagram. So process is midway between the input and the output. So process takes the input and processes as per the requirement and produces the output as required for a system. Now considering all these, if we can represent the control system by a block diagram, that is represented as shown here. So initially we have an input. So input are being sent to a controller. Controller process the data by a processor. So if correction is required or desired parameters are not being met, it is being adjusted, then it is being outputted through the output chamber. Now in between this input and output block, there can exist some sort of disturbances. So those disturbances may or might adversely affect the stability of a system, which is called as the value of a system. And usually these are unwanted signals and are to be eliminated. Now when we think of disturbances, there can be two different types of disturbances. As we have defined already, disturbances are nothing but these are the signal which tends to affect the stability of a system. If the system is not stable, that happens as a result of disturbances. Disturbances can be usually two types. One is internal disturbance, second one is external disturbance. So internals are generated within the systems, externals are generated outside the system. So let us try to understand the next part of a control system, which is very very basic. So that is types of control system. Types of control systems can be usually broadly classified depending upon various factors. So firstly we will see the classification of the types of control system depending upon the availability, such as natural control system and man-made control system. So natural control system is natural in nature, whereas man-made control systems are manufactured or designed by a human as per the required specification or as per the required existing or recommended levels. So the best examples for the natural control system can be a universe, and second one can be a human body. So I have shown an example considering a human body. So as we all know that the temperature of a human body tends to adjust depending upon the temperature that exists on the atmosphere. So this happens usually by the presence of sweat gland, which are present on the human skin surface. So this is a natural control system. As and when the temperature is increased, the temperature of human body is adjusted automatically depend upon the sweat glands which are present on the sweat pore on the skin surface of a human body. So the function of sweat gland is to adjust the temperature. Hence, we can call the human body as a kind of control system in which whose function is to control the temperature depend upon the requirement of environment. Now, considering a man-made control system, there can again these systems are again manufactured or designed by human. So the basic examples for man-made control system can be aeroplanes or else some process of chemical process. So when we look into the aeroplane system, so as we all know that the aeroplanes are designed in a particular manner in which the aeroplane control system is designed to fly over a space. And in the second example, wherein a chemical process is involved. So this is an example which shows a suitable controller which controls the flow of a liquid. So the flow of a liquid can be usually controlled by considering PID controller, depending upon the level of a liquid which is present in that chemical. So manual control systems can be again classified depending upon applications. So the very best example for manual temperature control systems is electric fan. So wherein the room temperature can be controlled by operating an electric switches by a human system. And similar to man control system, there can also be a water level controller. So in this process of control system, the input is mechanical in nature and or else it is operated manually. Whereas with respect to automatic control system, the operation of a system is automatic instead of operating manual. So the very basic examples for automatic control system can include home water heating systems, room temperature regulators, stabilizers, or else monitoring of human body temperature. The one more classification of control system can also be done based on the process of input and output are concerned, such as open loop control system and closed loop control system. So open loop control systems utilize a controller or a control to obtain the desired response. So in this open loop system, there is no effect of control action. So whatever may be the controller is receiving, it is being processed to a processor, and after processing, the output is obtained at the desired system. So in other way, we can say the input cannot have control over the output, or else the output doesn't have any control over the input signal. It only just process the controller signal received by the processor, or else we can say it is a without feedback system. So the basic examples for open loop control system can be washing machine, toaster, electric fan, microwave oven. And the other type of a control system can be closed loop control system. So in this case, maybe you can see a signal is being given to an input signal. So when a signal from output signal is fed to the input, the quality of output is once again compared by comparator signal called as comparator. Now once the comparison is done, the system can be adjusted as per the requirement, and then the controller processes the required input and produces the output which is required for the basic output system. So the basic examples for closed loop can be refrigerator, electric iron, or air condition. So with respect to refrigerator, maybe can be analyzed that whenever the temperature is decreases below the normal room temperature, the automatic operation of a refrigeration takes place so as to keep the refrigeration in process. So finally we look into the basic applications of a control system. So the basic application of a control system can be usually dealt with electrical or electronic devices such as switches, MCBs, controllers, PLCs. So basic applications of even electronic application can also be used in such as washing machine, coffee maker machine, water heater, stabilizers. And one more major application of control systems is in motor drives such as DC or AC motor drives. It can also be used in a satellite tracking system. It can also be used in aircraft controller. So I hope we have understood the basic meaning of a control system, block diagram of a control system, then a brief classification of control system, and finally the applications of control system. Thank you very much.